change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. As I turn up the collar on my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind. I see the kids in the street with not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them eat? A sonorous disregard, a broken bottle of time.
Right now, I guess I'm really, really tired, but I guess what's keeping me going is seeing those kids up on stage and thanking us for all the hard work that we're putting in. And all I'm thinking is that this is nothing compared to what they've had to go through, and I would dance forever for them.
I got a feeling that, you know, I can't let them down, even though I'm just dancing, and I can't get tired, I can't give up. They didn't give up, their doctors didn't give up, Chung's American Health didn't give up.
Who is this?
Eeyore, this is Fun Piglet.
Oh, dear.
Tyler Fleming is an adorable little boy with a playful sense of humor, but his bright smile conceals the fact that his life has been anything but easy. Tyler was born with Opitz syndrome. That's a complex condition that involves problems with breathing, swallowing, vision disorders, and neurological difficulties, including cerebral palsy. His parents, Kelly and Dave Fleming, remember.
So we knew what to expect, walking in there with tubes and IVs and alarms and some of that stuff. But then some of it's overwhelming.
It just seemed hopeless. But the doctors, the nurses, they gave us hope and they let us know that, hey, we're doing everything we possibly can.
Because of his breathing difficulties, Tyler has endured countless life-threatening bouts with bronchitis and pneumonia.
Because he has very sensitive system, he would get very sick. He would be on a ventilator for days on very high amount of oxygen.
And you develop a trust with these people because it's not just they're doing a job. We're entrusting our child's life to them.
A lot of the time he was in life-threatening respiratory failure.
When Tyler was almost a year old and they didn't think he was going to make it, the doctors were crying. They weren't just doing their job. They really care.
But Tyler is a fighter, and time after time, he's battled back against the odds.
A dinosaur?
No.
It's not a dinosaur.
It's a duck.
And now the spunky three-year-old is a favorite in Beaumont's therapy department.
Ready, go!
Where he's working to improve his coordination.
Nice job.
And to overcome his speech difficulties.
Can you say that louder? Say choo-choo train.
He has a tremendous drive and motivation to communicate. He works very, very hard. He's got a tremendous sense of humor. He's a real bright little boy. And he knows what this is all about. He knows that all of us here on the rehabilitation team are trying to help him. And I think that that's, you know, makes a big difference for him.
Say bye, Bear.
Bye, Bear.
Okay.
Tyler Fleming's spirit has brightened the lives of everyone around him. Especially his big brother, Michael.
Mary, Mary, Mary.
If it weren't for Beaumont, we wouldn't have Tyler with us today. There were a lot of heroic things that were done to keep him going, and we're very thankful for it.
Months ago, and they're amazing. I think my favorite thing is doing the line dances because they keep me going and I just go crazy and I make up my own steps and it's really funny. My friends and I laugh at each other, and I don't know, I think every time I hear these songs, I'm gonna be doing the line dance like in my sleep when I graduate everything.
I like to move it like moving. Don't you give up, don't you let her win. talking about a forever after. Don't you give up, don't you dare give in. Don't you give up, don't you dare give in. Doesn't it seem most precarious? Doesn't it seem such a chance to take? Doesn't it seem most precarious? Why does it feel like a big mistake? Please understand and hear what I'm saying. The time is now and you don't have long.
Give it up. We're behind you. Anything that we can do, we really appreciate what you're doing for us. Thanks. Have a nice night.
Marathon has been that I expected the best thing to be my friends and family coming and visiting me and taking care of me, but I think it's definitely been us taking care of each other.
Dave Ginsberg, dancer number 19, kids rock.
I've been dancing for many hours. I've never seen anything like this dance marathon ever, and I'm from Wisconsin, which means the state of Michigan is much better than the state of Wisconsin. God bless you, Children's Miracle Network, and God bless you, William Bowman Hospital. You are the reason why children are happy today.
Kids, yeah, we've been out here dancing for many hours, and for 30 hours, and for the kids, it's a really good cause, and I feel good about helping them all. And it's about booty music.
Thank you.
Championship Football. We have the Children's America Network, and we have the Dance Marathon. As everybody said, you know, we did what we had to do because we love our children, we're parents, and that's what we had to do, was raise our children. We did it. You guys are here because you wanted to. It's not mandatory that you take care of us. No, you're taking care of us because you want to. So, let's take this a little step further. Let's everybody stretch out their arms. Give yourself a big old hug.
You all, of course, entered that door 30-some hours ago with a strong desire to make a difference. You have made a difference, as endorsed by Hershey Rose. And then last, if I could invade probably each of yours most personal space, which I think is about 3 seconds before you go to bed each night, when your head is on a pillow and you're thinking about those things that are the most important to you, please remember for a very long time that you have made a very, very big difference. Thank you very, very much.
And soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call up my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running. Spring, summer, or fall. Now all you got to do is call, and I'll be there. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You've got to.